Loyola University Maryland sophomore guard Dylon Cormier had not made a three-pointer in just about two games, but it didn't matter with 3.1 seconds left in the contest when he drained one from the right corner to lift Loyola to a 61-60 victory over Manhattan College in Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference play on Thursday night in Reitz Arena.
4.8 seconds to go. Loyola looking to tie or possibly win. Walker with the shot to Cormier in the corner. He drilled it! Dylon Cormier!
Michael Alvarado's running 10-foot jumper with about 56 seconds to play gave Manhattan a one-point advantage, 59-58. Loyola came up empty at the offensive end after Alvarado's bucket, and then George Beeman was fouled after pulling down a defensive rebound. Beeman, who finished with the game-high 18 points, made only one of two, however, at the free-throw line, leaving the door open for the Greyhounds, trailing by two.
We felt optimistic about it, but we thought as a team, we practiced these situations all the time, 30 seconds being down one, so we just went into it and thought we executed, and I think we did a good job executing it. We came through with the win.
Loyola brought it down the court, but a shot was blocked out of bounds. The possession went back to the Greyhounds, setting up the final series. Shane Walker triggered the inbound, and after not being able to find Robert Olson, who was double-teamed, he saw Dylon Cormier in the low right corner. Cormier caught it, stepped behind the line, and drained the three with 3.1 seconds remaining.
We set up a play for a double screen to Robert to come off from the opposite baseline and me to stay on the wing just in case they cheated, and they cheated, tried to double-team. Shane made an excellent pass, and I just had to make the shot.
Manhattan was unable to get off a final shot, and Loyola improved to 10-4 overall, 3-1 in the MAC with the one-point victory. Neither team led by more than six in the game. Cormier put the Greyhounds up 54-48 with 7:09 to play, hitting two free throws. Manhattan, however, charged all the way back, scoring the next 7 points, taking the lead with 3:49 to go on a layup by Ramel Brown. A Loyola 30-second timeout came next, and on the ensuing play, Eric Etherly kicked it out to Robert Olson, who knocked down one of his 3 three-pointers to put Loyola back up, this time 57-55. Etherly had a game and career high 7 assists in the game to go along with 8 points and 6 rebounds. Olson finished with 9 points, all coming when he was 3 of 3 from behind the three-point arc. Beeman made a running jumper with 2:38 to play for Manhattan, tying it up at 57 apiece. But then after a foul by Michael Alvarado, Shane Walker made one of two at the free throw line with 2:09 to play, giving Loyola a 58-57 advantage. Neither team scored for over a minute before Alvarado's jumper put the Jaspers up by one. Cormier and Walker had 11 points, as did R.J. Williams. His 11 were a career high, and 9 of those sparked the Greyhounds in the first half. The Greyhounds continue action in Reitz Arena on Saturday afternoon when they host Canisius College at 12 noon. You can catch that by getting tickets at www.loyolagreyhounds.com. If you can't make it out to Reitz, remember you can watch all the action live and for free right here on Hounds Unleashed.